distance learning, as well as traditional in-person classes. The school board is set to vote on the plan next week. Leaders in Cocoa Beach have voted in favor of requiring people to wear masks while inside public places. Exceptions are being made for eating and exercising. Meantime, Deltona commissioners approved a mask resolution that doesn't mandate, but instead encourages people to wear masks in public. And it appears this year's hurricane season may be busier than first thought. Some leading forecasters are now calling for 20 named storms, up from the previous prediction of 16. 9 are expected to become hurricanes, including 4 major hurricanes. Remember, you can get breaking news around the clock on clickorlando.com and the News 6 app. I'm Justin Mormuth. Hope you have a great Wednesday.
WDYC, Altamont Springs. WYGC, High Springs.
A JVC broadcasting station.
660 AM, 105.5 FM.
Florida Man Radio.
Florida Man Radio. The views and opinions on this program are not necessarily those of this station, JVC Broadcasting, management, or its sponsors.
Yes, when somebody's trying to detain me when I don't want to be detained for no goddamn reason, yeah, that's how the f*** I act, naturally. Ask anybody who know me.
What you at school for?
The f*** are you talking about? Why are you detaining me? You about to lose your job. You about to lose your job. Get this dance. You about to lose your job because you are detaining me for nothing. And you're detaining me for nothing. And you about to lose your job. You ain't even got no job because you're training. You about to lose your job. You about to lose your job. You about to lose your job. Is it worth you losing your job? Because you about to. Because you ain't got no reason. I could pass any sobriety test.
You have Power Radio with attorney Justin Clark on Florida Man Radio.
Do you swear to tell the truth? The whole truth? To nothing but the truth?
You want answers? You want answers?
I want the truth!
You can't handle the truth!
And welcome to Wednesday morning, July the 8th, 2020. Justin Clark here, protecting you from the hypocrisy in America. You and I, together, we will bully the bullies. Today in the program, more protest in Orange County yesterday. But this time, it's the teachers protesting. They don't want to go back to school. Also, is it time to switch from Apple to Samsung? Because the new Apple iPhone will not include a charger. What? Quick housekeeping first. 321-329-1055 for your calls or text messages. Don't forget, download that new Florida Man Radio app. It's great. You can talk to us right there directly as well. If you want to watch this show, you can follow us on Facebook, Twitch, or YouTube at You Have Power Radio. Two TV shows for you this weekend and every weekend. Saturday, 12:30 p.m. over on our news partner, News 6, it is You Have Real Estate. And then Sunday morning at 10 a.m. on TV 27, it is Behind the Law Gray Show for you today. But first, the team. To my right, the beautiful Brianna. Hello, Brianna.
Hello, Justin.
Directly in front of me, pushing the buttons, it is Lurch.
Greetings and greetings.
321-339-1055.
And now it's time for the opening statement. This should be interesting.
When I'm in the market for an insurance agent, it's always sort of the nice guy, sales guy. We want to take care of you. I don't want to oversell you on insurance. No. We want to get you protected at the cheapest way possible. But it's always the nice guy, sales guy. I mean, insurance sales is somewhat the epitome of sales. However, if you want to really get an insurance agent upset, you roll into Costco and you find one not wearing a mask. And you see what happens. A man has been fired from his job at an insurance company called Ted Todd Insurance.
Ted
Ted Todd.
Yeah.
Double T.
Maybe they should change the name while they're on a firing spree anyway.
All right. Got a rebranding spree going on.
The company's CEO, Charlie Todd, I don't know who Ted is.
His partner.
But I figured the Todd part out.
All right.
Said on Twitter that this man's behavior in the video is in direct conflict with our company values.
Of course.
That his employee has been terminated. So what do you do as an insurance agent when you roll into Costco and you're one of these anti-mask people? And again, I don't care if we pass laws about masks or not. If they start to pass ordinances and they are going to punish us for not wearing a mask, that's where the line is drawn. However, if you're a business owner, you can make me wear panties into your store for all I care.
And you would happily.
You're a business owner. You have the right
he
to do that.
Way ahead of you.
You're not a government agency. You can require people to wear masks if you want. And then if people are going to hate you as a business for making people wear masks, then they won't shop. Like, if you don't want to wear a mask into Costco, you can go to Sam's Wholesale Club.
That's right.
Or go down to BJ's, where my family shops.
Mm-hmm. Or Walmart, where you shop.
Or the Super Walmart down the street. However, this guy was none too happy about being told by an elderly woman, by the way, who asked him to wear a mask. This was down at Costco in Fort Myers, Florida. Let's see how he reacts.
Oh, he's going to react so lovely.
Yeah, I bet.
Florida man.
I'm not harassing you. You are infecting us.
You're
coming close
back
to me.
Back off! Threat me again!
What?
Back the f*** up! Put your f***ing phone down!
Thank God for phones, number one. What did we do with crazy people before we had video cameras on our phones?
They got away with stuff.
Because, you know, when I was a child, it was a big deal to get a video camera. And it was like the size of China, these cameras. You could hardly hold them on your shoulder. You don't just roll into Costco with a video recorder back when I was a child.
He said, I'm recording.
I see you.
I just don't know we did with crazy folks back in the day. Mm. Now it's just a matter of you just hit the video thing.
That's
even though
right.
It takes me a little longer than most to find it because when I hit camera, it's always the actual camera first. So you got to slide over to video. And then I get confused about the whole light thing versus not. And then you got to figure out which way to point it. Do you point it at yourself or point it the other way? So it's a little more confusing for me than most. But I don't know what we did before we could video record crazy ass people like this.
Because even on CCTV, you wouldn't be able to really see like what is happening unless someone starts swinging.
How would you respond if you're an anti-mask person and you roll into Costco and an old lady comes up to you and says, we want you to wear a mask. Would you respond like this guy?
No.
What's his name? Can I give out his name?
Do it. And his address. We already know where he used to work at.
How would you feel if that was your grandmother
working
and you see some guy literally and he's looking like he's going to go Decker?
Yeah, right. You feel threatened by my 87-year-old grandmother?
She said, I feel threatened. Stop threatening me.
Yeah.
You know how dumb you sound, Ted Todd, man?
Meanwhile, the lady didn't hardly say anything other than, please put on your mask.
Right, like she did what she was paid to do.
I don't have dude's name, but I do know Ted Todd Insurance is, I don't know, maybe they're happy about this publicity. Not sure.
Hold on.
They shouldn't.
Just whatever you do.
Find them, Lurch.
You know, go to a different store. There's no reason to make a tour. The guy lost his job.
Yeah.
So if you don't like the mask thing, fine. I don't wear a mask. I don't typically wear a mask either.
We know.
Even though at my office now, I'm forced to wear a mask at my office.
He literally sits there. That sucker's like down below his nose. It's halfway covering his
mouth. It's very uncomfortable.
Mouth.
Yeah. And then I even get shamed occasionally. I feel like when I walk in the building here, I should have a mask on, but then I just like, whatever. I just pretend like I left it in the car or
you
something.
You get shamed? There's literally zero people in the who is shaming you?
You know who doesn't wear a mask here? The security guard. The guy in charge of our safety doesn't bother with the mask. So I'm like, look, if the security guard, the guy who's getting paid to protect me,
he's only
doesn't have to wear a mask, I'm not wearing
a
mask.
No, he wears one only when his boss is here.
Who's his boss?
The guy that owns the security company.
Who is the security guard who, when we used to do evenings here, would always escort you all the way down to the studio?
I'm
here.
Not giving his name.
Every day. Oh yeah, this was before work. When we used to do what do we do? Like 6 o'clock here.
Yeah.
This one too. The late night security guy was so infatuated with Brianna.
So creepy.
I mean, as soon as she walked in the front door to the office complex here. He would essentially hold hands with her all the way down to the station.
All the way back here. Oh, all the way back. And it was, like, bad because, like, early on, I didn't have, like, a key card. So he would, like, let me in the door, which I'm pretty sure is, like, a violation.
By early on, she means for the first 6 months she didn't have a key card.
I did not.
I mean, we have, what, Mitch? We have, you know, he would want to hold your hand. Right. I mean, man.
Mitch is still trying to pouch me last I checked.
Well, the man's name is... Justin.
No.
I was like, yeah.
Daniel Maples.
Daniel Maples. You got to chill, Dan. Danny-o.
Danny boy. Need some anger management.
I don't think I would put that on my resume as you're brushing up on it.
Do you think he would get his unemployment right away? As opposed to
sure.
other people?
If not, he's going to go down there and yell at them.
Of course. He's going to get unemployment. Absolutely. No question about
it. No, but I mean, is he going to get it right away? As in, as soon as he applies for it, he's going to get it instantly.
I doubt it. No,
get
I don't
paid
know.
More than he's been getting paid.
I don't know the wait time for unemployment anymore. I know they had issues with it before. I'm not sure.
What would you do? What's going Let's on say now. You have an employee of yours that kind of acts this way in public, and it's
traced
and it goes
back
viral.
To you.
Yeah, like what would you do? Would you
I don't know.
Fire them or would
I
you?
Would probably,
what if it was me?
I would use it as a teaching experience.
Sit me down.
Be like, I'm sending whatever his name is to,
to go talk
social
to
counseling.
But you wouldn't act on it. You would just be like,
I don't know.
Whatever, you're
I don't know. I hope I don't have to make any of those decisions.
I mean,
decisions.
I hope so as well, but.
I don't know what I would do. I would be.
I mean, I if you know. Really feel threatened, that's one thing, but. Come on, man.
I mean, also, like, he's in Fort Myers, and I don't, you know, like, I don't know how, like, tight-knit that community is.
Not
you know?
Very.
So they distanced themselves quickly. Like, this had nothing to do with his job. It wasn't like he went into another insurance company and was, like, flipping tables and yelling at people, you know?
If it was in Naples, it would be an instant fire. Fort Myers is a little bit bigger, and everyone doesn't know each other. Naples is a very, I gotta be, keep up with the Joneses type of place.
They quickly saw him and were just like, and that's it. We're going to have to let you go. I think that's been brewing for a while, though.
Now, I'm not saying if you, let's say you go out and you, like, start yelling at somebody, you should get fired for anything. But you have to look at everything as a whole. So in this instance, he's clearly yelling or going at an elderly woman. Mm-hmm. You can have a discussion or an argument outside with somebody. Doesn't mean you're going to get fired for calling them a jackass.
If something tells me this is not the first time this guy's had any issues with other human beings, if you know what I mean.
Yeah. No.
Orange County. Dozens of Orange County school teachers paraded around the school district's headquarters yesterday, urging leaders not to open campuses for in-person classes next month. Ooh. So August 10th is the day.
That's right.
That's when the kids go back to school, which seems early to me, but I say that same thing every year.
You do.
In fact, I always plan a vacation coming back around that time, and my daughter always misses the first couple of days of school because I can never believe it actually starts on August 10th.
What a great parent.
I know. Yeah, trust me. Don't worry. We have the Cozy app now. I shouldn't have that problem
should
anymore.
Should help them stay on a task.
Now, look, if I was... Yeah, I don't want to sit here and bash teachers, but I'm just saying if I was going to get paid
Please
for
don't.
Not having to work, I mean, I probably wouldn't want to go back either. That being said, their counter argument is they have to work anyway because they're going to have to do online schooling or whatever. So
right.
So teachers are going to have to work anyway. So you can't really use the argument, well, they're doing this because they don't want to work. But
no.
Maybe they don't want to go back to the office, so to speak. I don't know.
Or maybe they have other families.
The car parade and protest was organized by the local teachers union to coincide with the Orange County School Board meeting yesterday to discuss how to reopen schools in the middle of a pandemic. The school board met for 11 hours yesterday, and they're expected now to vote on what to do on July 14th. Any guesses on what is going to happen in Orange County? Are they going to go back to school or not? What do you think?
Our government has been a little wishy-washy with all this lately. They'll, like, say something, you know, like 8 a.m., and then by 6 p.m., they, like, change their minds.
You
so
think?
At this point, I don't know what the hell we're going to be doing. I don't know.
Didn't they just get some kind of a raise?
We will.
Like
yeah,
that?
They sure did.
That's
true. Big mind change happened in Miami, we're going to get to in a minute, too, yesterday.
Yeah, yeah. Like
by Mayor whatever. Jimenez.
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 The teacher, an art teacher at Howard Middle School, Clinton McCracken, said people are scared to death. And the Orange County Classroom Teachers Association, which is obviously their teachers association, doesn't want schools to reopen for in-person classes until new cases of the virus are declining, not spiking. All right, so fine. I mean, what if we're down to 3,000 a day or 4,000 a day by August 10th? Does that mean they want to go back? Because that means it's declining, correct?
Yeah. I mean, I don't know what number he's thinking about when he's talking about declining, but yeah. But I guess you also don't. It's going to be, I think, from the teacher's point of view a little bit, to play devil's advocate a bit here.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Is that a riot? What is that?
Yeah, that's the teachers downtown yesterday.
Oh, okay, they're pissed.
Yeah, we're not going back.
No.
We don't want to see your little punk kids. I mean, we'll talk to them online, but I don't want to see that little punk in person. What do you
Imagine
think I am, your babysitter?
These kids are about to be, though, because they had the whole last half of the year off. They've been out of school since, like, March. Like,
you think I'm your babysitter?
Man.
Please, don't give me the whole your property tax dollars pay my salary. Not a babysitter here, you little punk kid. It's bad enough having to talk to them online.
And here we are.
I don't know.
Yet here we are.
I don't think they want to go. I don't think they want to deal with the kids. Some of them don't want to deal with the kids. I'm sorry.
I think what they don't want to deal with is the confusion that comes with, you know, trying to implement something just to take it back. So yeah. Let's say you start school August 10th. Mm-hmm. Let's say 80% of your freaking students are now testing positive for COVID by August 16th. Now what happens? Now we got to scale back again. That whole crappy system with the going from in-person to online completely bombed. Everyone can agree with that. It completely bombed. Students didn't want to do it. The teachers weren't really implementing it. Teachers all over the place can agree that, like, it did not work out. They slapped it together. It didn't work out. So they're not really wanting to go back because they know what's going to happen.
Maybe we should create a bubble environment for them at Fun Spots. Kind of like the NBA did at Disney. We'll create a bubble environment for all the kids. And by the way, now not only are you going to deal with my kid from 8 till 3, you're going to overnights with my child, too.
He's in
Enjoy.
A bubble.
So, look, if you're worried about your health, let's create a bubble environment for you, and you can take care of them all day and night.
Bounce his ass out of the class.
Would you pay extra for them for that service? Oh, no.
No. I love my child.
Children.
I love my children. Shut up, both of you. Education Commissioner Richard Corcoran signed an executive order yesterday requiring school districts to make five-day-a-week on-campus lessons an option for all students whose parents want that, which I think is going to be a lot of parents by then.
Oh, absolutely.
Right now, they did a poll, and a third of parents say they want their kid definitely back in school now, and two-thirds say they're not sure. Trust me. When you have the option of sending your kid back, most of you are going to be like, all right, peace.
Absolutely. I mean, but you also have to think that, like, you know, the parents now, you have parents that are, for example, healthcare providers, you know.
Yeah.
Not going back to school is really not an option at this point.
Yeah.
What are they going to do with them? This five-year-old can't watch the six-year-old. You know what I'm saying? Like, they can't watch themselves. I have to go to work.
A lot of households that, you know, the ones that do have mom and dad still, which seems like not a lot.
Right.
A lot of moms and dads both work.
Both of them, right.
Right. So, I mean, the vast majority, I think, of people both work.
Well, what about for kids that already have health problems?
Well, then, you know, obviously we're going to make an exception for that.
They're going to be in a bubble outside.
Yeah.
Plenty of teachers are questioning how schools can reopen on August 10th when there are now more cases of the virus than there were when DeSantis closed schools in mid-March. That's a valid point, I guess.
That is. Rachel Ray's branching out. She went from cooking, and now she's fitting women for bras. I don't know what's happening right now.
I'm surprised I don't see Justin up there with panties.
321-339-1055. What do you think? Schools open? Should they close? And what Brianna's referring to is Lurch has Rachel Ray on in the studio now on the big screen.
Yes.
Why? Couldn't tell you.
Well, because our news partners actually come on before and then after. Our news partners.
This ain't news.
Bill Archer checks in. Hey, greetings, Bill. Everybody. Justin, chance to get some super cleaned shoes. Hurry while they're still open. LOL. And he sent a picture of Splitsville. Bill's referring to my propensity to steal bowling shoes after a long night of bowling.
To steal things, not just bowling shoes.
That's funny.
It is funny. Franklin the mailman is here. Good morning, my favorite crew. Good morning to you, Franklin. Fish is here, my brother Fish. What up? Morning, my peeps. Here, people, give the Justin Man card crack a break. It's more bland than Biden's hairy legs. Team Justin. Thank you, Fish.
Yes, Fish.
I mean, he's right on point there. Your whole man card thing is it's out of control. That a boy, Fish. That's for you, pal.
Well, speaking of yesterday, I'm on Instagram.
Yeah.
And I see, you know, little heart icon. So if somebody like follows you or whatever, I'm like, yeah. You know what? Who's following me? Attorney Justin Clark.
Oh, yeah.
Wow.
Finally.
It only took four months to get to that point.
I mean, we just keep breaking through barriers here.
It was probably me that followed you,
yeah,
honestly.
Yeah, probably.
Oh, speaking of, look at this guy.
Hey. I like the show now.
This is why I put it on.
My commercials are on now, so now I'm happy.
Did you play basketball before, or?
I don't know, but I'm still fat.
But I'm still fat.
I'm still fat.
And right afterwards, pizza.
Yeah. Karen is here. Hello, Karen. How are you? Good morning, my friends. Good morning to you, Karen. Dustin. What's up, Dustin? Dustin said, sup. Sup, sup.
Sup,
Al the mailman checks in. Good morning. Good morning to you, Al, sir. Chet with FedEx. Are we ever going to have a National FedEx Day anyway, or is it just going to be all postal service?
No, remember, they said that everyone's included.
Speaking of.
Oh, that's right.
Except for Amazon.
What?
It's so, because you know how yesterday we were talking about the national days and all that stuff.
Yes, I do.
Like, and I wanted to ask, I wanted to ask you, what if they had like some kind of like national father-daughter day? And I'm sure you would have said yes. Yesterday was like national father-daughter take a walk day.
Aww.
And we didn't even know.
I would do that. It
he
was?
Yeah, it was
walk.
Yesterday.
Whoa. It actually was national father.
Yeah.
No. See,
father-daughter take a walk day.
No. I love my kid.
Kids.
Jesus, there's two of them, Justin.
I love my kids, but I am not partaking in National Daughter Daddy Take a Walk Day. Are you out of your mind?
Yeah, I
will take my daughter to dinner or something for the heck of it.
It promotes the benefits of family bonding time between fathers and daughters. Mm-hmm. Notice how they use fathers and daughters, daughter, daughters.
Chet from FedEx. I'm sorry, I didn't check you in, buddy. Morning, my friends. Hope your day is going well. It is. Bebby in Tennessee is here. Hello, Bebby. Good morning. Bentley and Carver said you're doing a great show. Some would argue that, but thank you to Bentley and Carver. Dustin wants to know what the status is of the beanbag.
Dustin?
Well,
wants to know.
Yeah, so, I mean, the truth is, almost the last week, actually, I've had the room.
Wait.
I've had the full bed, yeah.
Wait, so where's she?
So where is she?
And like, one of the kids' rooms. Hey, I'm on TV again. I'm sorry. Okay. she's in one of the kids' rooms.
One of the kids'
I don't know how this worked. I don't know how it's worked, but I have gotten the bed for, like, a full week. Now, I will tell you, the dirty laundry thing is, at this point, overflowing. I'm going to have to take some action on that one way or another here shortly.
So what are you going to do?
In due time. I don't know, man. I know I'm not doing the laundry.
Are you going to hire somebody?
I guess I'm going to have to hire someone. You know what the weird thing is? We have a lady who was over cleaning the house this weekend, and they cleaned the house, but they left my laundry. I think that was probably pursuant to instructions.
Yeah,
don't you think?
Probably.
A little bit. That's kind of funny.
But the thing is, though, is it in her, like, job description or contract?
You really think I negotiated with the cleaning lady? No, I don't know anything about it. That's not my job.
He doesn't know anything about it.
Jeff Adams is here. Jeff, what's up? Hey, listening on my drive in, and welcome to the show. Thank you.
What's up, homie?
321-339-1055. All right, so I have three options here that Orange County is considering.
Oh.
They're going to vote on it next week. This has to do with your kids. On what the options are going to be when it comes to August 10th and your child or children going back to school. I'll tell you those three options and so much more to get to. It's a very quick break. Justin Clark on the Florida Man Radio Network.
You're listening to You Have Power Radio with attorney Justin Clark. Florida Man Radio. The Shannon Burke Show.
Cold hard cash.
Cold hard cash.
Stacks and stacks of green cash money.
Fat stacks.
buying hookers, drugs, things that you don't want people to know that you bought. You've been buying them with cash for years.
You can go down to the corner and get you an OxyContin for $30.
The Shannon Burke Show, afternoons from 3 to 7 on Florida Man Radio.
Oh, damn.
I'm personal injury attorney John Dill. You may have heard attorneys advertising about their success rate. It's important to find out that attorney's personal experience in the courtroom. I've tried more than 200 civil jury trials and recovered more than 200 million in jury verdicts. If you want a trial lawyer, get the real Dill. Offices, Orlando.
Get the real Dill, John Dill.
Does your water have a smell? What is it? And how to get rid of it? Tune in this and every Saturday at 9 a.m. for Water Talk, brought to you by Carter Water. When it comes to water, there are lies, damn lies, and crazy stuff in it. Water Talk on Florida Man Radio, Saturdays at 9 a.m.
Join the conversation on ATF as we talk everything whiskey, bourbon, rum, cigars, and guns every Saturday afternoon from 3 to 4. It's ATF on Florida Man Radio, brought to you by Bellicoso Cigars and Cafe in Mills 50 and Orlando FFL in Ocoee.
Adam and Eve is not giving you 10% off and not 20% off or even 40%. Your discount is even bigger. AdamandEve.com is giving you a whopping 50% off. But why stop there? In addition to 50% off, you also get 10 free gifts. That includes a racy item for him, a sensuous toy for her, and something we know you'll both enjoy.
Ooh.
And 6 extra special bonus items that are sure to rev your engine, pique your curiosity,
ooh,
and even blow you away. And best of all, free shipping, always delivered in discreet packaging. So rethink your bedroom routine. Go to adamandeve.com and enter the station's exclusive code at checkout, FLMAN, and get, you know the discount, 50% off almost any item and 10 tantalizing free gifts. That's FLMAN, FLMAN.
Hey, it's Shannon Burke. Looking to refinance your mortgage or buy a new home? You need to call my friend Dan O'Brien at Emerald Mortgage. Dan has 22 years of experience and access to the largest wholesale lenders in the country. He will find you the absolute best rate. 30-year rates are at historic lows, so refi and save hundreds to pay off your credit cards or buy that new home with a super low payment. Call Dan today at 407-468-6429. It's 407-468-6429 or emeraldmortgagepartners.com.
To make sure the air in your home is absolutely perfect, call Four Seasons Air Conditioning and Heating, offering $1,200 in rebates and payments as low as $132 a month on a new Lennox system. Call Four Seasons Air Conditioning and Heating at 407-295-9231 today. Conditions apply. See dealer for details. License number CAC056308.
Fuddruckers in Apopka and on East Colonial are open and ready to serve. Get a half-pound burger for only $4.99.
What?
You heard right. $4.99 for a half-pound burger. Available for pickup and now limited dining room seating. Visit their social media for more details.
The summer of trucks is in full effect right now down at Nations Trucks. Don't miss your chance to save thousands of dollars on your next truck purchase. Ford, Chevy, Ram, and GMC. Nations Trucks has got them all, and with approved credit, you won't make any payments for 120 days. The truck of your dreams is just a click away. Visit NationsTrucks.com today.
Tune in this and every Saturday from noon till 1 for Overdrive Radio's Car Advice Hour. Brought to you by Universal Tire and Auto in Longwood. Mike and his crew are here to inform and entertain you. Only on Florida Man Radio. Overdrive Radio's Car Advice Hour, Saturdays at noon.
Few things in law are more emotional and complex than divorce. I'm attorney Michael Breen. If you are contemplating a divorce or seeking modification of existing child support or alimony orders, a family law attorney is essential to protect you and your children's future. The law offices of Michael B. Breen can represent you right from the start and help you throughout the entire process. We will fight for your rights and help you pursue a fair resolution, one that is best for your family. For more information, visit 911familylaw.com. Offices, Altamont Springs.
Stop paying high electric bills and upgrade the value of your home today with a solar power system from IQ Power Solar. It's never been easier. With no money down and financing options available, you'll be using the power of the sun to take back control of your power needs in no time. Get a free consultation and assessment of your home savings opportunities by calling IQ Power Solar today at 407-585-1018. Or to learn more, visit iqpowersolar.com.
When good sleep seems impossible, Mattress Firm's Rest Assured Promise checks all the sleep boxes. The option to shop online, in-store, or by phone with a sleep expert? Check. Special financing? Check. Free shipping to your door? Check. A king-size mattress for the price of a queen, plus a free adjustable base with a qualified purchase of just $699? Check. Find your mattress at Mattress Firm. Offer valid with qualifying purchase. Restrictions apply. Valid at participating locations only. Visit mattressfirm.com for complete details.
How much money would you like to save just by doing something you're already doing? How about 40%? With Allstate, safe drivers can save 40% just by doing something they're already doing. Driving safe. That's right, 40% just by driving safe. Visit allstate.com or call a local agent for a quote today and see just how much you can save when you drive safe with Allstate.
Not available in every state. Savings vary and based on DriveWise and other safe driving discounts. Subject to terms, conditions, and availability. Allstate Fire and Casualty Insurance Company and affiliates, Northbrook, Illinois.
Florida Man is everywhere.
Everywhere.
Everywhere. In the car, on your radio at 660 AM and 105.5 FM. In the office or working from home, we're streaming live at floridamanradio.com. Out and about? On a run? Listen live on the free Florida Man Radio app and on your Alexa device by saying play 105.5 Florida Man Radio. There's no reason to miss any of your favorites, like the Bubba the Love Sponge Show.
Hey Alexa, who are the most famous Bubba's?
According to Blogspot.com, Bubba and Howard are kings of media.
Oh, whoa. Whoa.
You're like that guy on the beach with a metal detector who finally found something.
You have Power Radio with Justin Clark, The Ed Till Show, or The Shannon Burke Show.
At that point, I'm down hard. D-R-E-M dream.
Yeah, man.
Yeah, like Ronald Reagan and I are bowling.
Can I do a rail of cocaine on the back of the toilet?
Florida Man Radio. Unfiltered, unafraid. Get it how you need to. Now, back to You Have Power Radio with attorney Justin Clark.
Protest. Teachers protesting in Orange County. We don't want to go back to school yet. It's not safe, they say. Anyway, the Orange County School Board met for 11 hours yesterday, and they've rolled out three plans. So they can either vote on one of these, or they could vote on using all three of them, or whatever it is. So here are the options.
Let's do it.
Here are the options that they're going to roll out for Orange County, which I imagine then, as soon as they vote on it, Osceola County will do the same thing.
Of course.
Because that's what happens,
naturally,
correct?
Naturally, yes.
Anytime you have a little brother or little sister, like Orange County has Osceola County, after the big brother or sister rolls out a plan, the little brother or sister does the same thing. That's always what happens with Orange and Osceola County, right?
Let's see these options.
Seminole County's a little bit of a wild card anymore. I can't. I live in Seminole County. I know most of those people, but I don't know what they're doing up
Seminole
there anymore.
County.
It's because I have no idea. Officials, you guys are all welcome.
They reflect the people that live right. in the county
and the people that represent that county.
They're like, hey, Seminole County's like, we're not going to require masks, but all humans have to have a bubble around them at all times.
Right.
It's really shocking. I don't
Seminole
know what's
County's
going
like,
on there.
Yeah.
All right, option one, face-to-face, on campus, regular schedule, 5 days a week. And here's what you have to do. Staff and students all must wear face coverings for anyone over age three. You have to have scheduled hand-washing times. Is this like in soccer? Have you ever noticed now where like halfway through each half they have a timeout to go get a water break?
Well, yeah, it's halftime.
No. Halfway through each half, I'm telling you, they'll make them go get a water break now.
Usually what'll happen, let's say there's a foul, they're going to do a free kick or something. Yeah, they take advantage to try and drink some water real quick. And also, it's also tactical because the coach will tell one of the players, hey, let so-and-so know to start doing this, or this guy is doing this, or start doing that.
It saves on a timeout.
Two plus two is timeout. It's hand-washing time. Everyone go wash their hands.
I don't understand.
We'll get back to math in a minute. I mean, is it going to be like literally a bell ringing at 2:02? It's time for hand washing.
Does each classroom have a sink?
Look, I don't know. I have no idea.
Or does each like teacher walk around and spray the students' hands? Like, let me see you.
Yeah,
let
I don't.
Let me see the manos.
Also, daily temperature checks before entry for all staff and students.
That doesn't help.
social distancing when feasible. So that if they go all face to face, that's what they're going to require.
When feasible.
So it's basically guaranteed that kids and the teachers will be wearing face coverings. Or we'll go virtual, they say. Families who do not want children to return on-site would have the option of enrolling full-time in the Orange County Virtual School. Mm-hmm. How many more kids are going to be homeschooled after this? Probably a lot, don't you think?
I don't know.
Do you think homeschooled kids are weird?
No.
Oh, okay.
No.
Me neither.
Why not? No. You think they're weird.
I had this guy who worked for me for a long time. And he was homeschooled, and he was actually really normal. But I've just assumed that homeschooled kids are weird. Yes, my whole life I've assumed that.
There was a stigma once upon a time that the kids that were homeschooled and taught by their parents were a bit off.
Yeah. And this guy played sports, too. And I was like, well, what school do you play for? I don't understand.
Right.
Your mom?
But no, they have different programs now where they'll link you with your closest school. So you can, you know, learn and be in the environment of your home, but you're still associated with a school and can play for that school, represent that school.
Smartest people.
Yeah, I mean, he was actually not socially awkward, believe it or not. But I think he's the only one I've really gotten to know well.
Yeah.
That was actually homeschooled.
But
I certainly
Oh, okay.
I certainly judged them growing up.
So what did he say? What did he say about mental issues? Who has mental issues?
Anyone that has an annual pass.
Oh, yeah, that's right. And now homeschooled kids are weird.
That was me punching you.
I feel threatened.
What does that say? Ass slap? Wow.
Yeah. So that is option two is virtual learning. You've got to enroll in the Orange County Virtual School and blah, blah, blah.
Okay.
Number three, and lastly, innovative learning. They say the OCPS Launch Ed at Home program provides live stream for each lesson, follows a traditional bell schedule, but it provides location flexibility while also offering the continuity of student experience on campus as well as wraparound support services. Teachers will use a technology called Swivel. Ever heard of it?
Swivel? No. I've heard of Swindle.
Yeah. So students online receive the same instruction as those in the classroom. The family must commit for one semester at a time. And then the kid has to go back to school whenever feasibly possible.
I see.
That doesn't sound too bad, I guess. I mean, that's kind of like virtual learning, though. Yeah. I mean, does that mean they're like, in the regular teacher's classroom, but they're just watching virtually? I think.
No, it sounds like they're in... Maybe there's like designated the Swivel, is that what it's called?
Yeah.
Locations, you know, let's say like a movie theater, a church or whatever, and you're able to go to these designated locations and still partake of the same exact lessons on the same exact bell schedule as kids in a traditional learning environment.
Kind of like a Zoom meeting type thing at a law firm.
They say also you have to maximize distance, 3 to 6 feet, hygiene separation partitions between every student's workspace.
Oh, okay.
You have to have two school clinics now, a well room and a sick room, and prioritize cleaning. Is this one of these deals where if you get you get diagnosed with the virus that you're going to be judged by the other kid? Almost like having lice.
Yeah.
You remember how the kid who got lice when you were a kid? You're like, wow, stay away from that weirdo.
Actually, I remember the lice exams. You would all like line up and you would have them.
Yeah, I just wonder if all the other kids are going to make fun of the poor kid who gets the virus, because you know what's going to happen.
But see, I can see these new measures in like an elementary school being okay, but you start implementing these things in a high school with all these punk-ass kids that you don't know better.
They don't want
to learn. You think they're going to want to pay attention?
I just know for a fact I wouldn't hang out with Lice Boy for like a whole semester. That's true.
So
and now COVID Boy, COVID Girl.
Now you COVID Buddy. All right.
Have you ever seen that show? 3-2, if you want to join the program, 321-339-1055. You can text or call. Also, download the new app. Mm-hmm. Florida Man Radio app, any app store, and you can. Can't you send me a message on there, Lurch? Can you give me the whole scoop on this?
You go on the app. There's a thing called Open Mic.
Ooh.
So if you tap on Open Mic, you can record us a 30-second message that we could play on the air. Now, please keep it clean, as in don't cuss. But you can call Justin a dummy or a fat ass, whatever. But just
Beanbag Boy.
Yeah, Beanbag Boy. But just make sure you don't cuss. Because if not, it's not going to get played.
Have you seen this show on Netflix? It's a documentary called Lenox Hill.
No.
Oh, you got to watch it.
I have not, but it's great. Like New York, right?
It's New York Hospital, like real life stuff. They came out with a new episode last night that was filmed around like March 15th to April 15th at a hospital in Manhattan right when this whole thing was breaking out.
Nuts.
It was terrific. I loved it. But what you saw was a lot of first line of defense hospital workers were getting shipped in there from all over the country. They would have to send nurses and doctors and everything because there was a surge in patients, in virus patients. Well, yesterday, Governor Ron DeSantis said the state is sending in 100 contract nurses to Jackson Health System in Miami to help with a surge in the virus patients. What does this mean? Is it bad? Is it bad or no?
Wait, that he's sending?
Yeah, he's sending another 100 nurses down there from, like, Jacksonville or something to help with a surge in patients.
So he's sending them where? I'm sorry.
To Miami. Jackson Hospital. It's like the ORMC of Miami.
I see.
It's the Level 1 Trauma Center.
I mean, I could see how you would perceive it as bad because maybe, like, something is happening. But at the same time, thank goodness he's sending more help down there. Because if a certain part of the, let's say, state needs help, then why wouldn't you send more extra people to help.
Miami-Dade County has more than 1,600 hospitalized patients right now, double what it had 2 weeks ago, 331 in intensive care, and 168 on ventilators. Both numbers have doubled over the last 2 weeks, they say. Officials with Jackson said that the hospital still had plenty of beds, but it needed more nurses to relieve its overworked staff.
Yeah,
I'm not going to look into it that much.
You be hating facts.
Does it fit your agenda? Is that why?
Not going to look into it that much. I just wanted to let you know they are sending nurses down to Miami, kind of like they did in New York.
Well, wouldn't you, let's say if we're over one here in Orlando, wouldn't you want extra help, extra personnel to come in from different parts of the state that could help us? Wouldn't you want that?
Right. Sure.
So, because we're, you know, I think we can all, you know, we all know a medical professional. We can all, everyone in this room could probably say, I know a nurse from ORMC, and they say that their beds are empty. Well, good. Ship some of the asses down there to Miami.
And I know
to help
someone
out,
that,
or maybe their beds aren't as empty.
Someone that works in, not ORMC, but somewhere else, and like, no, you know, our beds are full.
Right. So this is also true. Yeah, this is also true.
Both sides.
So it's both sides. Where you can't have it.
Some breaking news today. Yesterday we addressed Brooks Brothers, and I told you they might be filing for bankruptcy sometime in the near future.
Did they do it?
After more than 200 years in business, Brooks Brothers has filed this morning for bankruptcy. Ooh. 200 years?
Wow.
Brooks Brothers, 200 years it's been around.
That's a long, long time.
Right.
Dressed the American business class in pinstripes for 200 years, two world wars. It's been through, but it cannot survive the virus. It joins a parade of U.S. retailers, Neiman Marcus, J. Crew, JCPenney. A Hertz rental car, Chesapeake Energy, just thousands of businesses have been filing for bankruptcy, basically. In a lot of ways, let me be clear with you, this has been a great excuse for a lot of businesses that had a ton of debt who were doing crappy to have an excuse to actually go out of business.
That's right.
It's a great time to, like, fire an employee that you've hated forever. Like, well, we need to downsize. You're going to have to downsize. No. You know you don't.
Get out.
You got your PPP and you're not even losing money. You just want an excuse to fire people.
Would you do that?
That's what Ted Todd did. They got rid of old noisy ass.
Oh, no, but he did it to himself.
Did he? Or was his sales low and they just kind of had to get rid of him?
Founded in 1818. 1818.
My God.
Brooks Brothers.
Oh, dang it.
Founded in 1818.
War of 1812.
Right.
It started selling clothes before the Erie Canal opened up and even before the California Gold Rush began.
The Industrial Revolution. Right. I mean,
they were out there panning junk.
It's been worn by dozens of U.S. presidents, including Abraham Lincoln and Teddy Roosevelt.
Wow.
It introduced the first button-down collar shirt. I mean, we didn't even have button-down shirts.
I didn't even know this. I'm going to be honest. Wow. I didn't know they had such a, you know. Like,
what did we do before? Hoodies? I don't know. I'm not sure. What kind of shirts did we wear before button-down collar?
We wore armor.
I mean, anytime you see, like, any reenactment, it's just like a regular shirt with, like, a giant V in the middle of it. There's no buttons or anything, you know, fancy. Just a shirt
well,
with a V.
You made it since 1818.
1818.
How's it going today? Bankruptcy. Wow. Isn't that kind of crazy? Mm.
Brooks Brothers, gone.
I mean, you know what, though? Someone will probably try to keep it open. Someone will try to buy them out.
Sure they will.
For pennies on the dollar. Mm-hmm. And then they're going to. I think they're going to stick around. But just because someone files Chapter 11 doesn't necessarily mean they're going to go away. Right. They can still try to stay in business.
Because they only have like $200 million in debt, right?
Only. We've gotten to a point where we say only $200 million in debt. Yeah.
I know. When you're talking about, like, you know, trillions to bail people out, like, it's $200 million is nothing at this point.
I was going
to
say, do we even know where one, like, a store is?
A Brooks Brothers store is located? No idea.
In Orlando? I have absolutely no idea. Know.
Well, they have, I guess, factory outlets, but it all says temporarily closed.
Yeah. That's for a while.
Yeah,
to let them employees go.
I wouldn't go wait in line for the next 3-for-1 suit sale, if you know what I'm saying.
Oh, it's the Mall Millennia. It opens at 11.
Clearance, 70% off.
It opens, they really opening today?
No, the Brooks Brothers in at the Mall of Millennia.
Really?
Yeah, but the factory outlet stores are closed because the outlets are closed.
Well, I'm online and they say they have a 70% off like clearance. Ooh. One item right now. Normally it's $11.98, so $1,198 going for $359.40.
Sounds like a bargain.
Yeah. Snatch that up.
Oh, man. Wow. All right, let's check your text messages again. If you want to join the program, it's 321-339-1055. Henry is here. Hello, Henry. All FedExers are here now.
Hey, hey.
National FedEx Week sounds good to me. Mm-hmm. How about National Screw the Amazon Driver Week?
Yes.
You want to do that, or that's too much? Is that going too far?
But what happens if you have Amazon drivers that listen to your show, Justin?
Well, we'll throw them right in there. Yes, absolutely. We'll create Cindy. Hello, Cindy. Good morning, three entrepreneurs. Best show. Thank you. Oh, Dustin says it's time for her to find herself a man that holds a man card.
Is that what Dustin said?
Oh, Karen, thank you very much. She said she'll do my laundry.
Is that what she's doing in the other room? Looking for a man with a man card?
Karen's going to do my laundry. That's all I'm adding.
Question with the laundry, though. Is that only your clothes or is it everyone's clothes?
No, it's mostly mine, but I've seen some little kid clothes in there, too.
Well, I mean, you know, gotta make it seem. As
yeah,
if.
Right.
Well, it was me. I threw some in there.
Oh, one more thing. You didn't give us an update, so you didn't play basketball this morning, correct?
I played basketball this morning at 5:30 until 7:30.
When you got home, did you lay in bed again with your sweaty ass clothes?
No, I went right
clothes?
To the shower. Okay. I didn't want to hear your all nonsense right. this morning. I went directly to the shower.
Did we even change those sheets out for Monday?
Yeah,
or?
Did you?
Because that's important too.
I did not know. No, I'm not even doing laundry. You think I'm changing my sheets? Are you crazy?
Okay, you're right. That was a dumb question. That was a stupid question.
No, but look, I can barely put a dish in the sink. Yeah, or change sheets.
Because, you know,
you're out of your mind.
Obviously.
Dave the drummer is here. Hello, Dave. Good morning from Atlanta. Excellent show, as always.
Hey,
thank you very much. Franklin does think, screw the Amazon drivers.
Oh. Y'all, I get way too much stuff from Amazon. I'm going to need y'all to calm down.
I mean, let's keep this rhetoric up until someone does call or text that they're working for Amazon.
Yeah, hush that noise.
I mean, honestly, though, even if they worked at Amazon, they're probably going to complain about them because they are pretty tough on their employees, I believe, correct?
Not like their delivery guys.
No?
They, like, do a lot of, like almost like Uber.
I heard Amazon mistreats its robots in its factory, let alone the humans.
They probably do. I don't know. I can't speak for the robots.
They have the robots at 100% speed.
They're the first company to ever get sued for overtime while it's robots. It's true. Not true. Joke.
Feel how hot those bolts are. See that?
Now you can have robots calling you now.
No, I'm going to have Jeff Bezos suing me.
Right.
That's what I don't want. Jeff... Look, I know you don't overwork your robots.
Actually, no, that's a good thing. Jeff Bezos, if you want to follow me on Twitter, Lurch FMR, bash
drag
me, please.
Him.
Harass me, please.
Dunkin' Donuts apparently not doing so well either, which is a little bit surprising because it seems like everything out of there has been all positivity.
Yeah.
They even changed their name from Dunkin' Donuts to just Dunkin'.
Yeah.
To go more of a, I don't know, food-oriented or take the donut out of it because it's fattening. I don't know why they did it. I don't know why they've rebranded. I don't like it. But anyone who's ever lived in Boston for any amount of time, you know that Dunkin' Donuts is the spot. I mean, we wouldn't even go to Starbucks. Yeah. And there's a Dunkin' Donuts on not every corner, like two on every corner.
Yeah.
Dunkin' is very much Boston.
It is.
Uh-oh. Real customers are telling you what their holidays.
Here's how Boston people feel about Dunkin' Donuts. This is Saturday Night Live, by the way.
Peppermint Dunkachino. With the Dunkin' app, I can order and pay on my smartphone, so my coffee's waiting for me when I walk in.
I love Dunkin', man. What are you talking about?
Where else can I get breakfast and the perfect stocking stuffer?
You want to talk real customers? Kid, that's me. I'm like the mayor of Dunkin'. This is the face of Dunkin' Donuts right there.
Hey, you can't smoke in here, man.
I'm not, Mark. I'm not smoking.
You're smoking in here.
You're smoking in here.
Yeah, I come down to Dunkin' every day. Grab a Corolla, have an extra large, three Parliaments, take a big dump. That's kind of the routine. Right over there. This douchebag will move when I'm ready.
And with Dunkin' Rewards app, there's even more reason to celebrate the season.
Yo, free coffee! I got the big one.
I got a free coffee right there on the app.
Show and tell something? Huh? With a little show and tell, Dunkin' Nuts. Show that, mama.
Tis the season for holiday drinks. Like
right,
our
never mind that. Hey, interview my buddy Julie for the movie right here.
Never
Julie,
mind
show me
that.
The donut is.
Anyway, that is sort of how we feel about Dunkin'
never
Donuts.
Never mind that.
And when you go to Dunkin' Donuts in Boston, everyone just gets the regular. Oh, what are you having today?
Regular.
Oh, the regular. And you know what regular means? Regular means cream and sugar. That's regular. I thought regular probably meant like black when I first moved there, but regular means cream and sugar.
Regular. Yeah. Is that how you would talk when you lived in Boston?
Not really.
That's how he talks after four White Claws.
Yeah.
You can tell he starts to get drunk when that Boston accent comes out.
By the end of this year, Dunkin' will close approximately 450 locations and Speedway gas stations across the country.
Not the Speedway.
Yeah, Starbucks also announced in June it plans to close 400 company-owned locations. So I guess bad time for coffee? I'm not sure. It seems like they're doing fine to me. I got to wait in line at the Starbucks near my house for like an hour. Every single morning, it seems. They're not going to shut that one down, I assure you. Dunkin' said, by exiting these sites, we are confident we'll be better positioned to serve these trade areas with Dunkin's newest next-generation restaurant design that offers a broader menu and modern experience. So what are they trying to do here? Are they trying to become more a breakfast restaurant place?
I think they're just trying to be more like everything place. Because like the Dunkin' Donuts and... In Jacksonville, they have like a co-working space.
A
on
co-working
the top floor.
Space.
Yeah.
Jeez.
And they've opened this one up like, I don't know, 2-3 years ago.
Hey, look, there are a lot of Bostonians be rolling around in their grave if you tell me that Dunkin's trying to go co-worker space.
Yeah. That's what I'm saying. Like, and people like chill out there at that Dunkin' Donuts. They have, you know, they utilize the space. It's free to use. You just buy it, whatever the hell you want to buy. It has like a smart board in there. It's nice.
See, I think we go to Dunkin' Donuts because they don't have the co-working space. We don't have to look at the dude with the newspaper and his laptop out.
People aren't posting.
That's why we go to Dunkin', so we don't have to deal with co-worker space.
Oh, not that new
Come
one.
On, pal. It's a movie. Tell me what your favorite. How you like the vanilla nut taps?
It's a movie. What?
The vanilla nut taps.
Oh, it's a
cut your nails, for God's sake.
Great, Donnie.
Oh, yeah, go outside.
Best part of my day is when I'm at Dunkin'. Think that's sad?
Yes, very.
Real customers know. The holidays run on Dunkin'.
What is happening?
Back to Starbucks.
He just threw the Dunkin' Donuts coffee.
Did he say go back to Starbucks? What? He used it like it was a derogatory term. Go back to Starbucks. Jesus.
He's run on Dunkin'.
Go back to Starbucks.
3-2-1. 339-1055.
I'm dead. That was funny.
I mean, if you had to choose, if there was a Dunkin' and Starbucks next door to each other right now, Brianna, where would you go? Dunkin' or Starbucks?
Normally, I'll go to Dunkin' Donuts.
For real? Oh, yeah, but remember,
you
Shannon
see
was,
my Dunkin' cup in here
the other
time.
The other day, she left a Dunkin' Donuts cup here in my area, and Shando freaked out and started sending Twitter messages to me, blaming me. And it was a freaking like caramel latte chilled blah blah blah.
He assumed it was
and
yours.
I was like, first of all, I'm more offended that you're accusing me of drinking a caramel flavored coffee, Shando. And you're fine. It's one thing to blame me for leaving it out, which it wasn't me.
Mm-hmm.
It's another thing to blame me for leaving out a caramel flavored coffee.
So
you
two
you
things.
You don't like caramel flavored coffee?
No.
No.
I'm not gonna
he takes
order
his coffee
it.
Black with two Splendas. That's it. That's it. Black, yeah, two Splendas.
What's the drama over there? Someone called to complain?
Oh, no, it was a pickup prize, though.
Oh.
No one's
Oh, I thought it was an Amazon worker. I was like, pass him through.
I know. I was like, look, if it's an Amazon Prime driver, let's put him on the air now and let's figure something out.
We're still close
patch
here.
Him
so.
In. So two things here. Yeah. One, the only reason why my cup was over there is because I had to clean your freaking station, all right?
Yeah,
I had to clean your workstation. Yeah, yeah. So blame the me. Cup wouldn't have even been over there had I not had to clean up after you. That was one. Two, please also note that Shannon was dragging you. The second I got in and admitted the cup was mine, he stopped.
Ooh.
And with that, I'll sip my coffee.
That's a good point. I mean, shots fired. Shots fired.
Two very good points have been made. So, you know, we're gonna rest the case right there.
3-2-1. 339. 1055.
Go back to stop us.
I was protesting you.
Oh.
If the teachers can protest, so can I.
I'm making a protest.
We can protest about anything now, really, can't we?
I was going to say, what would you protest for?
Right now, I'm protesting her leaving a damn coffee with caramel flavored on my station over here.
But if there was something,
and me taking the blame.
Let's say lawyers, there's a new bill passes in Florida that lawyers have to pay 50% of their wages or whatever.
Lurch, I'm going to be honest with you, pal. I'm pretty busy. I don't necessarily think I have time to protest anything. I don't. I really don't. I think I would just try to find a new job,
let's
a new
say
profession.
Like, oh, I know. Like,
I don't have time to protest anything.
What if you had to start wearing masks when you tape your TV shows?
I'm not going to protest. I will wear a mask or I'll just tell them to go piss off and I'll find another station.
Here's Attorney Justin Clark. Yeah. Reporting live, you have real estate.
Yeah, no. If some TV station wants to make me wear a mask, I'll do one of two things. I'll wear a mask.
Welcome to the show.
Or I'll say, hey, yeah, go piss off. I'm going to find another. There's other stations in town.
Go back to Starbucks.
What if all the stations require you to have a face mask?
Well,
while you're
I don't move to Tampa. I don't know. What do you mean to tell you?
Don't just throw the whole city away, dang.
Yeah. Move to Tampa's closer to the beach anyway.
Just throw the whole city away. I'm out. I'm done. I've been sick of Orlando for a minute.
You know?
Okay.
Yeah, well, you're going to be further away from Bike Week in Daytona. Oh, crap.
Oh, no.
What a disaster. What a... no way.
Worst.
To Bike Week. Come on.
So Bike you wouldn't week. Even go to Bike Week?
We got to take a break.
Talk about the same guy.
When we come back, Walmart is now trying to continue their competition with Prime. They're rolling out a Walmart Plus to compete with this... Amazon Prime. I'll tell you what benefits you can get and how much it'll cost you, and really tons more to get to. Stick around. Justin Clark on the Florida Man Radio Network.
You're listening to You Have Power Radio with Attorney Justin Clark. Florida Man Radio.
Previously on the Bubba Loves Fun Show.
They airlift you just for a blowed off hand?
You can bleed out.
The first paramedic said, do you have insurance? He said, yeah. They go, fine, send in the helicopter.
That's right.
Seattle Dispatch, we need a full-blown helicopter deal. Guys got Blue Cross Blue Shield with a Humana kicker. We need as much stuff as we can roll up.
I got the Golden Rule insurance. Are they airlifting me, or are they
no,
just going to send me an Uber?
No, they're taking
you by rickshaw.
Bubba the Love Sponge, morning 6 till 10 on Florida Man Radio.
This is Sergeant Slayer, a 10. Today's orders are to go to WeKillFloridaBugs.com. Say it again.
WeKillFloridaBugs.com.
WeKillFloridaBugs.com is home of Mighty Tech Pest Management. Get in touch with Mighty Tech today for residential and commercial pest control, termites, wildlife exclusion, and removal. And if mosquitoes are a problem, ask Mighty Tech about them as well. Call for a free evaluation today. 1-888-750-7378.
Say it again.
WeKillFloridaBugs.com.
Dismissed.
Adam and Eve is not giving you 10% off and not 20% off or even 40%. Your discount is even bigger. AdamandEve.com is giving you a whopping 50% off. But why stop there? In addition to 50% off, you also get 10 free gifts. That includes a racy item for him, a sensuous toy for her, and something we know you'll both enjoy.
Ooh.
And 6 extra special bonus items that are sure to rev your engine, pique your curiosity,
ooh,
and even blow you away. And best of all, free shipping. Always delivered in discreet packaging. So rethink your bedroom routine. Go to adamandeve.com and enter the station's exclusive code at checkout, FLMAN, and get, you know the discount, 50% off almost any item and 10 tantalizing free gifts. That's FLMAN, FLMAN.
If you missed Rad Law Radio last Saturday, you missed a great time. Join me, Robert Dushman, this Saturday at 11 a.m. for free legal advice and a fun review of this week's legal issues. You'll also get my totally unbiased opinions. This week's show is sponsored by The Flooring Resource, Central Florida's leading flooring supplier. Your floors are going to look better just by looking at their Facebook page.
The arts are alive and well in Orlando, and we want to let you know what's going on. Join Chase Shilley, that's me, every Saturday from 2 to 3 to get to know the writers, musicians, artists, performers, and filmmakers who make up the rich landscape of Orlando arts and culture.
Are you a business owner? Well, first of all, thanks for listening. If you want to find new customers, we can help on Orlando's newest radio station, WDYZ Florida Man Radio, 105.5 FM, 660 AM. Your ad could be featured right here in the morning with Bubba the Love Sponge. Key placement 10 till noon in You Have Power Radio with Justin Clark. Noon till 3 with The Ed Till Show. Or in Prime PM Drive during The Shannon Burke Show. We can create a custom campaign based on your goals and budget. Drive store traffic, engage new clients, develop more leads, boost website activation, and get your cash registered to ring with new business. Radio gets results, and JVC Broadcasting is ready to help take your business to the next level. For more information on increasing your success, visit our website at floridamanradio.com and click on the Advertise tab. Drive store traffic, engage new clients, develop more leads, boost website activation, and get your cash registered to ring with new business. Let us help you grow your business.
Reach out today, unfiltered, unafraid. floridamanradio.com. Click on the Advertise tab. Do it now.
Recently, a new client called me and started by saying, "Mr. Morgan, I really need your help, but I'm just a nobody." Those words stunned me, and I immediately called him back, and we're now helping him and his family after a terrible accident. I'm John Morgan of Morgan & Morgan. Everybody who comes to our firm at their time of need is a somebody. I grew up poor, but my grandmother was like a queen to us. At Morgan & Morgan, our goal is to level the playing field for you and your family at your time of need. The insurance company has unlimited money and resources. You need a firm who can fight them toe-to-toe. For right at 30 years, we have fought them in courtrooms throughout America. Our results speak for themselves. And always remember this, everybody is a somebody, and nobody is a nobody. Visit ForThePeople.com to learn about our firm, Morgan & Morgan, For the People. Dial pound law on your cell. Pound law, that's all. Offices, Orlando.
If you're dealing with stress, pain, or sleeplessness, look for all-natural solutions from Cannabidiol Life, Central Florida's premier CBD distributor. Cannabidiol Life uses a U.S.-patented extraction technology that produces the highest quality CBD on the market. Florida Man listeners can save 30% off their entire order with promo code FloridaMan at checkout. CBDOilsAndEdibles.com to check out their huge selection of tasty edibles, oil extracts, smokables, and topical creams that could relieve your ailments. CBDOilsAndEdibles.com, promo code FloridaMan for 30% off.
Give our shiny new toy a test drive. It's the all-new Florida Man Radio app. Your one-stop shop for all your Florida Man fixins. Enable push notifications to find out the big Florida Man Radio contest, interviews, shows, and more. Use the open mic feature to throw your two cents into the conversation by recording a message that we could play on air. Download the all-new Florida Man Radio app in your Google Play and App Store now. Powered by CentralFloridaArborCare.com.
Hey, what you doing?
I'm checking my credit score on an app, but I had no idea my credit score was so low. What am I going to do?
Don't worry. Trade Guardian offers credit repair and credit counseling. Their monthly coaching program allows you to get your updated credit report every month. You can start seeing results in as soon as 30 days.
Wow, but that sounds like that's going to be expensive.
Not at all. Trade Guardian offers a free credit assessment to evaluate your options.
That sounds great. How do I get started?
Claim your free credit assessment from Trade Guardian today to start building the credit that you deserve. Find out more at MyTradeGuardian.com. That's MyTradeGuardian.com.
I'm News 6 anchor Justin Warmoth. Here are your Wednesday headlines. The Orange County School District has laid out its plans for reopening schools in the midst of the pandemic. It includes giving parents three options for fall learning, including structured and non-structured distance learning, as well as traditional in-person classes. The school board is set to vote on the plan next week. Leaders in Cocoa Beach have voted in favor of requiring people to wear masks while inside public places. Exceptions are being made for eating and exercising. Meantime, Deltona commissioners approved a mask resolution that doesn't mandate, but instead encourages people to wear masks in public. And it appears this year's hurricane season may be busier than first thought. Some leading forecasters are now calling for 20 named storms, up from the previous prediction of 16. 9 are expected to become hurricanes, including 4 major hurricanes. Remember, you can get breaking news around the clock on clickorlando.com and the News 6 app. I'm Justin Mormuth. Hope you have a great Wednesday.
WDYC, Altamont Springs. WYGC, High Springs.
A JVC broadcasting station.
660 AM, 105.5 FM.
Florida Man Radio.
Now, back to You Have Power Radio with attorney Justin Clark.
Start with some breaking news here in hour number two. Anyone want to take a stab at the new positive Florida cases of the virus? Brianna, I'll start with you.
Yesterday was like 6-something, right?
Yes.
Okay, let's do 4-8.
Lurch?
6,193.
9,989. So, look, we kept it in four figures, not 10,000.
I'm gagging.
Oh, but let's see. How many deaths? 48 new deaths, which is not a ton. Not as many people dying, but certainly a lot more cases.
It means a lot to those 48 people. Yeah. Oh, sorry.
It sure does.
I'm sorry.
If you want to join the program, it's 321-339-1055. Eunice checks in. Hello, Eunice. How are you?
Hey, girl.
Oh, Justin's going to need a beanbag at the station.
Damn.
And then she said, damn, Brianna, LOL. What did you say to me in the before the break?
I think it was my two points.
Yeah.
Steve checks in. Hey, Steve, how are you? Can we as Americans sue the Democratic Party for fraud with the misleading numbers of false positives?
Oh, my God.
Wrong death labeling and fear tactics. I don't know. He also wants to reduce our property taxes now that our public services on schools are not 100% functional. Probably not going to happen,
yeah.
I would say.
Sorry, fam.
Keith checks in. If BLM is a company, which from my research it is, legally can they be hate crimed? Also, Dunkin' Donuts is only closing Speedway locations. They lost the contract. And it makes sense. Isn't Speedway, don't they have, like, their own coffee? Don't they have, like, an awesome coffee bar for a gas station?
No.
No?
I think you're talking about Racetrack.
I don't know what I'm talking about. But
Racetrack has a decent one. Wawa has a, man, it's like the mother of all coffee bars.
Yeah, Al the Mailman says Amazon needs to keep to the right side of the road and stop blocking the mailboxes, rat bastards.
They actually do.
That is true, though. They are.
They do.
Yeah.
That
is true. I kind of
I've seen
that.
It happen a lot. I've seen it happen.
321-339-105. Everybody hates on Amazon, but we all order from there.
Oh, I don't hate on Amazon at all, honey.
I don't do positive Amazon stories on this program.
I don't know why.
But Walmart, also hating on Amazon. Walmart will unveil its subscription service, Walmart Plus, later in July. So later this month. It was going to do it earlier, but you know what happened, I guess, since March. We had a little thing.
COVID.
Yeah. For $98 a year, subscribers will gain access to same-day delivery on groceries and merchandise. You'll also be privy to discounts at Walmart gas stations and gain early access to deals from the nation's largest retailer. Yeah. But Prime has the video deal.
Yeah, but it has
to be. That's the difference.
Kind of spiteful because I believe with Prime it's $99 a year.
I think I have that information here. So
yeah, I'm sorry. How much is it?
No, it's Amazon's program, which entices shoppers through exclusive deals and faster shipping and streaming, is $119 a year.
Oh, really?
Right. But the thing is,
so
it's
like
everything.
$20.
It's everything because you get free grocery delivery with Amazon. You get quicker packages. You also get a streaming, so like free TV, free videos, free music, books, audiobooks. It's a lot.
Yeah.
Like, you're getting a lot.
I don't think I would give up my Amazon Prime because of the video thing.
But see, Walmart Plus doesn't make sense to you because you go there almost every day, so it doesn't even...
And you know what?
Right.
And please, look, if I'm going to say a prayer this evening, I would say, dear God, whatever we do, Can we please not put Walmart now in the movie business too? Because I got enough crappy Netflix movies. Oh, it's Netflix original. And then we got enough crappy Amazon Prime original. I can't take any. I cannot do Walmart original movies.
What would a Walmart original movie look like?
It would look bad.
Right, Walmart original. It's like all the employees they should have had out on the floor are back there recording freaking movies and stuff.
It would probably be one of those deals, like, you know, if you get hired somewhere, they have the little produce deal for new hires that you got to sit there and watch that film.
Oh, yeah.
It would be something like that.
Those same guys.
Welcome to the team. No, please, Walmart, don't do it. Even if you're going to do a movie deal, don't go. Let's not make your own movies.
I think the best move for Walmart would be to buy Redbox. Ooh. And put them bitches in every Walmart and get that money.
Yeah, right. No one is even going to take the time to stop at the Redbox box anymore.
I've seen people stop at the Redbox box.
Yeah, they're called 90-year-olds.
No. There's a certain
they
brand of
90-year-olds who don't know how to work that Fire Stick.
And the okay.
Especially at the 7-Eleven on Cermon and Old Cheney.
No one goes to Redbox anymore.
No.
When's the last time you've been to a Redbox?
Oh,
maybe if you were staying in a cabin in Maine with no internet is the only way you would ever, ever go to a Redbox.
Okay.
Who's an actor or actress that you really like?
I don't know. Brianna, go ahead. I don't like
that. Don't put me on the spot. I don't know. Dwayne The Rock Johnson.
I was going to say, because if you like somebody, and let's say they are coming out in a Walmart original series or something,
sure.
That entice you to.
No, I don't like any actor or any. No, I don't like any actor enough to watch a horrible, terrible movie.
But that's what Netflix did. They started buying up the actors and putting these people in these like cheaply B movies.
Hey, Adam Sandler, we're going to give you $1 billion, but you're going to need to pump out 8 horrible films a year. Can you do that?
Yeah. Uncut Gems.
Absolutely.
Was like the end for me.
Absolutely. I can do 8 horrible movies a year for you. For $1 billion? Sure.
At the end of Uncut Gems, I was done.
I haven't seen it. Is it terrible?
What? Yes.
It was awful, huh?
It's just you knew it was going to happen, and you were just kind of prayed it didn't happen, and then it happened, and you were like, freaking stupid me sitting here for 2 hours watching this crap.
It's just too much of that going on
literally.
Right now, really.
I knew it was going to happen. They had the same 6 people in the whole movie.
That's me watching an Amazon Prime original.
That's you on the beanbag.
Yeah. I'm sorry. Real quick question. Did y'all watch Hamilton this weekend, though?
No.
I have not yet. It is on the to-do list.
It is. You need to put it back on. Then you need to move it to the top. Yeah. Rearrange it.
It's on the Eunice has been very...
I'm 2.5 views in. Eunice, put some pressure.
Vocal
where Precious
about it.
Needs to go. Okay?
Hold on, though. This is me watching a Netflix original.
Can you also put you in a lawyer meeting?
This is me in a lawyer meeting.
It's him in a lawyer meeting. That's him bullying the bullies, guys.
Look, hey, Walmart, listen to me. Listen up. If you want us to boycott your dumb Walmart Plus service, we see what you're doing. You're trying to compete with Amazon. In fact, we're somewhat impressed that you've gone from brick and mortar to really competing pretty well with Amazon when it comes to ordering crap online. We're impressed. But let me tell you something. If indeed you create Walmart Films, and you do a Walmart Films originally, I am canceling my Walmart Plus subscription immediately.
Why you already have a Walmart Plus subscription?
No, I don't. Yeah. But I'll probably end up getting one.
2 questions.
And if you create a original film section at Walmart, we're canceling. Done. Okay, go ahead.
One's more of a statement. Well,
yeah.
Yeah. So one, don't. Oh, it was a question, actually. Sorry, my bad, in my head. So
a question typically ends with a question mark.
I understand
statement
that.
Will have a period at the
I,
end.
I get that. Thank you. Psycho.
Sorry.
Question number one, why does everyone feel when they put plus at the end of it, like it just makes it better?
I don't know.
Okay, because everyone's been like doing this thing plus.
Yeah,
thing
plus. I don't know. I don't know. I can't explain it.
I think Disney's going to be pissed. All right, and two, did you know that Walmart drops a Christmas album every year?
Absolutely not. I did not. Don't remind me as we get closer to Christmas.
It's actually called the Walmart like choir.
Oh,
like
that's
they
really
have, it's
wow.
Like employees and they're like vest or whatever, blue or yellow or that.
Well, I know what our bumper music for Christmas
yeah.
is.
Yeah, it's gonna be straight Walmart.
It's the Walmart choir, and it's
It was reported that sales are up 37% online year over year for Walmart. So they're really increasing their online presence for sure.
Makes sense.
And they're expecting to end the year up 44.2%. To $41 billion, which is ahead of eBay. Does anyone use eBay anymore?
I used it last month sometime.
What, he bought a Michael Jordan rookie card? I mean, what do you buy on eBay anymore?
Yeah,
a signed Mickey Mantle baseball.
Yeah, I actually bought a part for a vending machine. Long story, but yeah. The only place I found it was on eBay.
A part for a vending machine.
Yeah. And randomly enough, where it was... It was located in Orlando.
Really?
So I actually got to meet up with the guy and like and save on the $40 shipping.
Oh, that's always comfortable. I'd rather pay the $40.
So you have the vending machine, or is it a vending machine in the place you frequent?
Yeah, I have a vending machine. I have several vending machines, but I needed a part for it, and that particular part, serial number and all, was they had it on eBay.
They didn't know you had vending machines. Yeah. Oh, dang.
Some things.
Where at? Like
downtown.
Really?
Yeah.
Is it like chips, like Snickers? Or
no,
is
it's actually hygiene items for the homeless.
Chet wants Walmart to finally start their own delivery service. Then they might realize how badly they pack groceries. They put a case of water, case of soda, 5 jars of spaghetti sauce all in one box and put paper tape on the bottom.
Then when
you pick it up, bam, bottom rips and it looks like you had a murder on your hands with all that spaghetti sauce. Dave agrees with me. Speedway has decent coffee. I went to a Speedway. I know that you're saying racetrack, but I'm sure it was a Speedway, and they had like a whole like you grind your own coffee right in front of you.
Isn't there one right here on Fairbanks?
I don't know.
On Aloma, right?
Not sure.
I don't know. Is that a Speedway? Speedway is the blue, yellow.
Why isn't it like the white and red?
I don't know. Henry's firing shots at Amazon, saying you might get your Amazon stuff fast if they would ever deliver it to the right address.
Ah, you guys are crazy.
Bam.
Henry.
Fish said, Walmart making movies? I'd rather watch Murder, She Wrote. Me too, pal. Me too.
So you're saying you would watch Murder, She Wrote?
As opposed to a Walmart original?
That's actually on Netflix.
I would rather watch Hallmark Channel wire to wire than any Walmart original.
So then, are you doing anything this weekend?
Watching Murder, She Wrote.
I'm not doing none of the above.
Can we pick a Hallmark movie and have you review it after?
If you would like, sure.
Yes.
I mean, I might nap quite a bit.
Hallmark movie.
Through it. I might nap a lot. I don't know. 321-339-1055. Apple! Mm. What are you doing, Apple? Come on, man. So, anyway, I don't know if your house is anything like mine. But finding a charger for your phone at my house is an absolute disaster. So I said, here's what you should do. Since we're on Amazon around here all the time, why don't you go on Amazon and order like 10 chargers? Like, just load us up. Load this house up with chargers. And my family did that about 3 weeks ago.
Smart.
I think they ordered 6. If anyone in my house is listening, let me know how many you ordered. But I'm thinking over under about 5.5. That's a lot of chargers. There's no more. They're gone.
Really?
I mean, where are they? My house eats chargers. You can't charge your phone at my house. And I don't know if people are hiding them from me. I don't know what's going on. But my home appears to eat chargers.
Makes sense.
But the good thing is, anytime you go buy a new Apple phone, you get a fresh set of fresh charger and headphones. Mm. And by the way, Apple, whoever came up with the idea to make your headphones the charging plug thing too, you should be fired. Because if you're on any kind of road trip or anything, you can't charge and listen at the same time. Do you know what I'm talking about, or am I the only one that's been frustrated with this?
I think you're the only one because
Why can't you have two separate holes? One to charge it, one to listen to crap.
Yep.
I don't understand this.
But that happened a while ago. But yes, there was pushback. But
there was a lot of
pushback. They're going to do whatever they want to do.
Well, Apple is coming up with the iPhone 12. Typically, they roll it out in September. Although this time, for the first time ever, they will not be including a charger or headphones in the package. But why is this?
Does it cost less?
Of course not. They're just trying to be cheap. And here's what you're going to do. And here's what you're going to do. And I think it's a plan. Because we're not going to put a charger in there, and we know your house eats chargers, so you're going to roll up to 7-Eleven and buy the $4 charger, which breaks your phone, and then you got to buy a new phone. Isn't that how it works?
Or it doesn't even charge your phone at all, or you leave it on there, and after 3 hours, it went from 4% to 6%.
I think it kills the batteries of your phone or something when you buy the $4 7-Eleven charger, and I think they do it purposely, so you have to buy new phones faster. Mm. So, but now... They're not going to even include that good charger that they put in the box. You know that cute little box they give you when you buy the new phone?
Mm-hmm.
and it has the charger and the headphones, you're like, oh, sweet, I'm going to keep up with this one.
No, you're not.
Wow, yeah, right. I'm going to put these headphones in a special place. Mm-hmm. And then 2 days later, you can't find them.
Can't even find it. Gone.
But at least you know when you buy one, it's worth the investment because you're going to get a free charger and headphones out of the deal. Well, not anymore. Apple's now expected to roll out 4 different iPhone 12 models this year.
Okay.
Including its first version that will be able to work with 5G. Doesn't my phone say 5G sometimes anyway, or no? Am I, maybe it's 4G.
It may be 4G.
I think I see 5G on there sometimes.
You might.
But they're not going to give us any headphones and no charger?
I don't know. Apparently my cousin has an iPhone, and she said that it comes with an adapter, so you can put both holes in there if you put the adapter in there.
iPhone said, and I quote, "A lot of existing iPhone users already have many of them over the past few years."
Okay.
Not me, pal.
Well,
I don't have a single charger, from what I can tell.
Probably not.
I mean, seriously, it's like a fight in my house.
I have four.
Four?
Yeah, I have chargers everywhere because I know, like, I have them where I need to be at. So I always have one, like, on me. It's my travel charger. I have one in my car. There's one by my bedside, and then there's one where I sit at on the couch. Occasionally, I'll have one. Like, my travel one is, like, for work also, since we've been working from home, or sometimes not. So
Al the mailman wants to bash Amazon Prime. What's up, Al?
I don't know. Well,
he's thinking about it.
A lot of Amazon drivers are putting packages in the mailbox, and we just take them out and send it back to them, postage due.
I love it.
Dang.
That's great. Why? Because they don't want to walk to the door, or what would make them do that?
They don't want to walk to the door. Yeah. I could see the picture now with the package in the mailbox. When they're not supposed to put it there. But the problem you have with your chargers, I'm going to fix that right away. And I think they might be in cahoots with Lowe's. Go to Lowe's, pick up yourself new outlets, and in the outlet that has a charger port, some of them have two, some of them have one. So all you got to do is plug it in.
Hold on. Say this again. This might be some good advice. Tell me that one more time. I want to make sure I'm following you here.
Okay. You know where you plug in something at your house, the outlet.
The thing that you don't put metal in, right?
Exactly.
Okay.
You might have did it when you were a kid, but
clearly I did.
Definitely did it when he was a kid.
So in those outlets, they have adapters in it that you could just plug your phone right in there. Yeah, you need a cord, but it's always there.
I think the problem is it's not like he's missing the box, Al. He's missing the whole freaking cord. He'd be losing the whole thing.
You know who's got the cheapest cord? I'll tell you right now, and they last the longest. What the hell's the name of this store?
Dollar General.
Dollar
General. Big Lots.
Five Below.
It's a new place. It's in something low.
Five Below.
Five Below. Boom. Yeah, you can get them there cheap.
Yeah.
Right there. Boom, boom, boom. Amazon Blow.
Amazon Blow?
All right. Hey, Al, have a great day, brother. Peace. Amazon
said, though, the whole
signing
Amazon
off. Signing off. Oh, Farrell checked in. No chance Justin knows how to change out an outlet.
This is also true.
Damn straight.
That was making a huge assumption right there.
Georgia boy, what's up, man? How are you? Here's an idea. Buy different than Apple. They're good, but they're just as good for better value. Yeah, what do you think? Samsung versus Apple. I know some people who are Samsung lovers.
I'm an Apple guy.
Yeah, me too. But I don't know. I think
Android.
I could switch it up one of these days.
I mean, I've switched to Android before, yes, but I've always gone back to Apple.
I've switched to Apple, and I've always gone back to Android.
Georgia boy said he controls his kids' money, and until they can afford to buy a new charger, they got to pay for it themselves, you know? If they can't find a charger, he's not going to give them his. They got to buy it.
So he goes to Five Below.
Maybe you should buy a beanbag that has a charging thing in there.
That's a brilliant plan.
In the beanbag.
Franklin the mailman says he's had to help stupid-ass Amazon drivers find a house that was right in front of them. Hey, bud. Hey, USPS guy. Have you seen 1442 Main Street? Yeah, dummy. It's right in front of you. Dummy.
That's funny.
321-339-1055. When we get back, Deutsche Bank slammed yesterday. I mean, these guys, first of all, they had a lot to do with the foreclosure crisis back 10 years ago or so. But now apparently they really helped this Jeffrey Epstein absolute maniac perpetrate some of these financial crimes that helped them do, you know, what he did, right? Mm-hmm. I'll tell you what they did and how much they were fined. One more quick break. Justin Clark on the Florida Man Radio Network.
You're listening to You Have Power Radio with attorney Justin Clark. Florida Man Radio. The Ed Till Show.
Busy, crazy week this week. You know, great listener, and he brought up such a great topic. It's a very good parallel for his topic. When it comes to politicians, it shouldn't it be the opposite of parents? Like, parents are for a lifetime. Shouldn't every politician serve two terms and be done, no matter what office?
The Ed Till Show, weekdays from noon till 3 on Florida Man Radio. Florida Man Radio proudly backs the blue. Each month, we salute law enforcement all over Central Florida with barbecue for the blue. If you'd like your local department recognized, text us now at 321-339-1055 and give us your name and department. Thank you to all law enforcement officers for what you do every day. Florida Man Radio proudly backs the blue.
Johnny Leone with Seminole Power Sports Sanford. It's getting hot. What better time than now to get out on two or three wheels and feel the breeze in your hair and the warm sun on your skin. With 2020 inventory dwindling down, we are excited to say the 2021 product is starting to ship. Be the first in your riding group to get one. Come see the new Honda, Kawasaki, Yamaha, and Can-Am motorcycles firsthand here in our 40,000 square foot showroom. Test rides available and special discounts on pre-orders. Only at Seminole Power Sports, your number one in fast fun. Ride the adventure, live the dream.
Time to burn those COVID calories, so get off your ass and hit Fit to Row in College Park, Orlando's premium indoor rowing studio. Open now. Lose weight, tone up, get fit with no contracts. A full body workout that's easy on the joints. Go to fittorow.net now or call 407-325-4781. That's 407-325-4781. Stay tuned to Florida Man Radio for your chance to win 3 free months at Fit to Row.
Hey, it's Jeff from the Shannon Burke Show. And as you know, Four Seasons AC has made the Florida Man Studio so comfortable that Bubba needs a Afghan. Brian and his team of Four Seasons AC are badass, and I'm using them for my home too. Four Seasons AC, 4acnow.com. The AC company you wish you call first.
Tune in this and every Saturday from noon till 1 for Overdrive Radio's Car Advice Hour. Brought to you by Universal Tire and Auto in Longwood. Mike and his crew are here to inform and entertain you. Only on Florida Man Radio. Overdrive Radio's Car Advice Hour. Saturdays at noon.
If you're dealing with stress, pain, or sleeplessness, look for all-natural solutions from Cannabidiol Life, Central Florida's premier CBD distributor. Cannabidiol Life uses a U.S. patented extraction technology that produces the highest quality CBD on the market. Florida Man listeners can save 30% off their entire order with promo code FloridaMan at checkout. CBDOilsAndEdibles.com to check out their huge selection of tasty edibles, oil extracts, smokables, and topical creams that could relieve your ailments. CBDOilsAndEdibles.com, promo code FloridaMan for 30% off.
If you missed Rad Law Radio last Saturday, you missed a great time. Join me, Robert Dushman, this Saturday at 11 a.m. for free legal advice and a fun review of this week's legal issues. You'll also get my totally unbiased opinions. This week's show is sponsored by The Flooring Resource, Central Florida's leading flooring supplier. Your floors are going to look better just by looking at their Facebook page.
When good sleep seems impossible, Mattress Firm's Rest Assured Promise checks all the sleep boxes. The option to shop online, in-store, or by phone with a sleep expert? Check. Special financing? Check. Free shipping to your door. Check. A king-size mattress for the price of a queen, plus a free adjustable base with a qualified purchase of just $6.99? Check. Find your mattress at Mattress Firm. Offer valid with qualifying purchase. Restrictions apply. Valid at participating locations only. Visit mattressfirm.com for complete details.
How much money would you like to save just by doing something you're already doing? How about 40%? With Allstate, safe drivers can save 40% just by doing something they're already doing. Driving safe. That's right, 40% just by driving safe. Visit Allstate.com or call a local agent for a quote today and see just how much you can save when you drive safe with Allstate.
Not available in every state. Savings vary and based on DriveWise and other safe driving discounts. Subject to terms, conditions, and availability. Allstate Fire and Casualty Insurance Company and affiliates, Northbrook, Illinois.
Bubba the Love Sponge.
Hey, it's Bubba the Love Sponge. Listen every weekday mornings right here on Florida Man Radio, powered by Anajar and Levine, accident attorneys. Call 1-800-747-FREE. That's 1-800-747-3733. Lake County, it's time to feel the rush and push the limit at Seminole Power Sports North in Eustis. Find your excitement in our giant showroom with a selection of new motorcycles, ATVs, side-by-sides, and personal watercraft. Seminole Power Sports North has it all. Yamaha, Honda, Kawasaki, Suzuki, Can-Am, and Sea-Doo. There's a team of dedicated service technicians to fix it right the first time, on time. In July, mention this ad and receive a $250 gift card and 10% off parts and service when you purchase a new or used on-road motorcycle. Your number one and fast fun dealer is Seminole Power Sports North on Highway 441 in Eustis.
Have you thought of a career in real estate, or are you looking for a different way to grow and market your listings? You Have Realty is hiring and has opportunities for agents who can take advantage of our global approach to marketing. We can advertise your listings on TV, radio, and social media. Call 407-733-4700 for a confidential interview to discuss taking your career to the next level and the opportunity to work with our partner, Justin Clark.
Florida Man is everywhere.
Everywhere. Everywhere.
In the car, on your radio at 660 AM and 105.5 FM. In the office or working from home, we're streaming live at FloridaManRadio.com. Out and about? On a run? Listen live on the free Florida Man Radio app and on your Alexa device by saying play 105.5 Florida Man Radio. There's no reason to miss any of your favorites, like the Bubba the Love Sponge Show.
Hey Alexa, who are the most famous Bubbas?
According to Blogspot.com, Bubba and Howard are kings of media.
Oh, whoa. Whoa.
You're like that guy on the beach with a metal detector who finally found something.
You Have Power Radio with Justin Clark, The Ed Till Show, or The Shannon Burke Show.
At that point, I'm down hard. D-R-E-M drink.
Yeah,
man. Yeah, like Ronald Reagan and I are bowling.
Can I do a rail of cocaine at the back of the toilet?
Florida Man Radio. Unfiltered, unafraid. Get it how you need to. Now, back to You Have Power Radio with attorney Justin Clark.
Hey, can you buy like a big stone that's so heavy that can't be moved, that's a charger or something? I mean, is there something I could put on my nightstand that people literally can't move? Seriously.
Yeah, just get like one of the flat chargers.
But don't you think they can just pick that up just like any other charger? There's got to be something that's like really a pain in the you-know-what for people to move.
Buy one and just keep it in your bag or whatever at all times.
Yeah, because that's a whole other deal. Now I got something else to deal with all day long. No. I don't. Now I got to carry a charger around. I got enough bags and crap and a briefcase. Now I got to carry the what?
There's a paperweight charger.
Really?
Unfortunately, you have to order it through Amazon.
Weather looks great here, by the way. If anyone's in Florida, let me tell you.
Yeah.
Wonderful day to get out.
I was like, are you trying to look for wildlife, or what are you doing?
Someone just brought me a check here that I got to take to the TV station, and it's soaked. The check is drenched.
Oh, dang.
Oh, beautiful day. So Georgia Boy tells me to pay attention to the apps put out on the charger, looking for at least 2-amp output. Amazon multi-packs are the highest rated. So what does it say what the output is on the packaging or something?
Oh, hell, I don't know.
Well, maybe when you look,
it looks like a salt lamp.
Browsing.
What? Oh, yeah. But like, if I go to 7-Eleven, is it going to say, oh, this is a 1-amp?
No.
It's going to say iPhone charger or Android charger.
Yeah, that's it.
That's it. Charger.
Dave said to be careful using non-Apple Lightning cables. iTech Deals had genuine Apple cables for $6. Yeah. I would have loaded up. He loaded up because his Colombian wife loses them.
His Colombian wife.
I'm not saying.
Colombian
I'm
wife?
Not saying anything, brother.
Yeah, are not at liberty to say anything.
I have no idea. I don't know anything about Colombian wives losing charges.
Nor insinuate. No. Or presume or assume.
No, I'm not saying anything. I mean, what do you think? I'm crazy here? You think I'm nuts? Huh? Colombian. I mean, no, that wasn't me.
Are you going to go back to the beanbag tonight? Which,
like,
by
it.
The way, we have not seen a picture of the beanbag.
I know. What's wrong with you?
I keep thinking about taking one for you, and I always forget.
Yeah.
Where it's so comfortable, I'm not going to get up and take a picture.
It'll be
I'm
selfie.
I'm chilling.
It'll be a selfie of this man.
He's going to have White Claw. He's going to have Walmart Plus.
Right.
You know,
streaming
one,
in the background.
Lap, yeah.
Have you watched the Jeffrey Epstein special on Netflix?
Yes.
Not yet.
Now, Netflix does well on these documentaries and things.
They
so,
sure
they,
do.
They need to stay away from Netflix originals.
Mm-hmm.
But you know, documentaries and true crime mm-hmm. stuff, I'm cool with it.
I'm binging it.
Well, Deutsche Bank got slammed yesterday for their dealings with Jeffrey Epstein, fined $150 million yesterday for being for making sloppy mistakes and just being overly sloppy in its relationship with accused sex trafficker Jeffrey Epstein.
My God.
Authorities said Deutsche Bank's significant compliance failures allowed Epstein to conduct hundreds of transactions totaling millions of dollars that should have prompted additional scrutiny. Let me tell you what happened. I mean, it's pretty obvious. Go ahead.
Isn't the president alleged with, like, Deutsche Bank or something like that? Or
I don't. Yeah, I mean, I think president got a loan here or there, maybe. Not sure. A lot of them from overseas, too. But anyway, the suspicious transactions flagged included payments to individuals who were publicly alleged to have been Epstein's co-conspirators in sexually abusing young women, as well as many payments to Russian models, school tuitions for many women,
Jesus.
Hotel expenses, and direct payments to numerous women with Eastern European last names.
We're not doing this.
Hey, surprising, huh? Aren't you surprised? Deutsche Bank acknowledged its error of onboarding Epstein in 2013 and the weaknesses in our processes. And we've learnt from our mistakes and shortcomings. So, here's the deal. First of all, he was taking out more than $200,000 in cash annually. Mm-hmm. But also, keep in mind, Epstein, he got charged in 2006 regarding all this nastiness he was doing. So they didn't bring him on board until 2013.
Wow.
So they should have kind of been on the lookout for some really weird stuff that was going
on.
Despite knowing Mr. Epstein's terrible criminal history, the bank inexcusably failed to detect or prevent millions of dollars of suspicious transaction, according to the New York State DFS.
So bounce her tuition check? What were they supposed to prevent?
Also, there was a personal attorney of Epstein who DFS says had the authority to withdraw cash from his accounts and did so 97 times between 2013 and 2017. Keep in mind, remember, every time they came for a massage, he would pay cash, right? Every single time.
I know someone else who pays cash.
You keep saying that. You're actually wrong on this one.
At the Asian massage parlor.
No, you're wrong. Wrong.
You pay cash on a lot of things.
I do pay cash for a lot of things.
Is that a special bell?
But this lawyer went there 97 times to his. This was like his big account there, right? Where he trades and does all the things. Between 2013 and 2017, withdrew a total of $800,000 in cash. 2 to 3 times a month, the attorney would show up and withdraw the maximum amount of $7,500 for the daily withdrawal.
Wow.
Epstein told the bank his attorney needed the cash for travel, tipping, and expenses. Twice between 2014 and 2017, the attorney asked the bank how often he could withdraw cash without triggering an alert. So, I mean, these guys just let him do it. You know, money's great.
Yeah.
Let me tell you something. You got money, you can do whatever you
money
want.
Money is power. Is what it is.
Anything that you want,
it's
you can
funny.
Go.
Like, that's what people like Jeffrey Epstein assume, is that because you have money, you can buy your way out of a lot of situations. And
which
unfortunately, he did buy his way out of a lot of situations. And I think America's getting to the point where we're just, you know, we're cracking down on things like that, which is why his bank is now getting fined for crap that he did.
What a guy! I mean,
conveniently enough, they're getting fined the exact same amount that could bail out the Brooks Brothers.
Now we've got the other girl in prison or in jail. I believe in the same jail he was in, Brooklyn.
Yeah,
right. Isn't that? I think that's where Epstein was as well.
I believe so.
But she's on like 24 hour. She can't go to the bathroom without someone being there.
She got someone literally chained to her,
watching her. Absolutely.
What they should have done is when they captured her. They should have had her, like, right then and there.
Immediately.
Write down, say everything, do everything, because
if you die, you probably will.
You think she's going to talk or not?
Yeah, I think she's
Miss
gonna
Maxwell.
Talk.
Is Maxwell going to talk? Is she going to roll?
I think she's going to roll.
I think she's going to roll, too, because
I don't know how deep she's going
to
roll.
I mean, she grew up rich to begin with, and then he made her rich as well.
Mm-hmm.
I don't think she's going to like spending time in prison. That's who's going
to
rule.
Is he going to have the same sort of when he first went to jail where he was able to get out and he
No, they're not letting her out. No way.
Like, he got out on work release or some crap. Like,
no way. No. Judge is not going to let her out.
Or is
no
she going to have like a Martha Stewart setup where she's in a separate wing of the jail and it's like not.
She's the epitome of flight risk.
It's like basically like a 3-star hotel, which is like hell for them.
And they, she just
but
bought
it's not a hotel.
She was hiding out in I think New Hampshire, and she bought the house cash, like over $1 million house.
Right up the street from where they
everyone's
like
she's in Paris. She was in New Hampshire.
She was up the street
at a house that she just bought.
If you see a lot of let's say like movies or TV shows and things like that, where they're trying to find somebody, they're always
right
up the road.
Right.
Yeah, exactly.
Right.
It's not new.
I would have, like, text Snowden and been like, hey, where you at? Russia still? Let me come see.
Where is Snowden, by the way? Is he still in an embassy somewhere or
they
something?
They said he was last in Russia, and then he just kind of fell off the grid. He's probably back by now. You know, COVID done hit, and he was like, hey, looking for me no more. Let me go back to my
house. How funny would it be if Trump just pardoned him, dude? Hey, well, by the way, you know what's-his-face is supposed to show up in prison in, like, 6 days. Bubba the Love Sponge Boy. Stone. Roger Stone.
Really?
Yeah, I mean, everyone's taking bets right now if Trump's going to pardon Roger Stone in the next 6 days. Mm-hmm. I think he's going to do it. Trump is here bashing Bubba Wallace for creating a fake noose, according to him. Why does he care if he pardons Roger Stone?
Well, because I think when, I guess, on Trump's to-do list, Roger Stone is loyal and has stayed loyal to him. So.
Yeah.
He's going to be like, okay, yeah, sure.
But why hasn't he pardoned him yet?
Why hasn't the Tiger King been pardoned?
That one might be going a little too far.
We have priorities out here.
That's going too far. Patrick checks in. Hey, Patrick, blame the Germans. Deutsche Bank's German. Deutsche Bank's a German company. I have seen this, actually. Farrell said you got to watch the remake of Unsolved Mysteries on Netflix. Surprise, surprise. The first one's from good old Baltimore here in Maryland.
It is.
I thought this was an old... this is new?
No. So Netflix, they relaunched the series Unsolved Mysteries. They have six different mysteries.
But I thought
this
was from like 1990.
Right. The original series was from 1990, but Netflix, you know, bought the rights to it. And now they brought up, six of them. I just finished it yesterday and bomb.
But hold on, time
absolutely
out.
Absolutely bomb.
Time out. Is this the old cases or are these new cases?
I mean, they're all cold cases. That's why they're Unsolved Mysteries.
Oh, but they've already run on Unsolved Mysteries and they're still there?
No. Come on. Like, I think the oldest case that they had was from, like, it happened to start in the 90s, mm-hmm. but, like, it's, you know, a lot of this stuff is
but these
current.
Aren't just reruns from the
no,
same
these
show. These are
reruns.
New shows.
This is a new show. Oh.
See, I would have probably checked this out already.
Do it. It's six episodes.
Who is the host of that show?
There's no host. It's literally just like a docudrama, right?
Do you ever watch Snapped?
Yes.
I do, too, and I shouldn't.
You probably shouldn't. Not in your household. Oh.
I'm going to stop. What are you talking about? I'm not saying that if I see Gatorade laying around, I get a little concerned at times.
She's going to make him a Robert Kissel milkshake.
What is
have
that?
Have Sophia freaking walking in.
I don't drink Gatorade.
Like
the
wife the
house.
Made him a poisonous milkshake and had his daughter walking into him and he drank it because it came from his daughter.
Because, I mean, don't they always poison you with Gatorade? It's always in the Gatorade, isn't it?
She put it in a milkshake.
They put
arsenic? I don't know.
You can use arsenic or there's also the...
Cyanide?
Something you put in the car and it looks like Gatorade.
Oh, antifreeze.
Yeah.
It's the antifreeze and the Gatorade that gets him every time.
So you're afraid of antifreeze.
Do you even drink enough Gatorade to make that plausible?
I don't drink a lot of Gatorade.
When you play basketball, do you just drink water? Or?
Yeah, I have a Gatorade water bottle that I fill up every morning about 5:10 a.m. before I head out.
Mm. What time do you wake up?
Wake up about 4:45.
Dang.
What time do you go to bed?
Which time? Because it seems like I wake up all throughout the night. But I go to bed at like seriously 10 o'clock.
So normally you would be in bed by 10.
Yeah, at least laying down, watching Unsolved Snapped. I'm not watching Snapped anymore. I'm done with that show.
I'm telling you, watch Unsolved Mysteries.
Is it still possible to block shows like you do for kids? Can we do adult blocking?
Block Snapped.
I want to block Snapped. I want to block the whole damn channel. What channel is that?
So
anyone know?
The last Unsolved Mysteries, though, this lady, you know, she, like, went ham, and she started, like, knocking them husbands off, though, you know, and got her kids involved. It was nuts.
Yeah, what channel was Snapped? I'm gonna block it.
It does sound like Oxygen, doesn't
it? Yeah, it seems like Oxygen.
Right. It's going to be adult block.
Cut that Oxygen off.
Hey, what else is on Oxygen, though? I want to make sure I'm not missing anything good.
I don't know.
You know what I watched last night? Linux Hill, which was great. Mm-hmm. And what's the one where they're on the boat? The Below Deck. I watched Below Deck.
I wish I had time to watch.
Well, that's
TV
why I told
shows.
You at the end of the show. Outsmarted you today. Thank you for joining me. Thank you for joining us. I got a whole stack of stuff I didn't get to today.
That's okay.
But that's good.
Brianna, I want to find out more about you. How do I do so?
Brianna Daniel Official, all social media.
Lurch.
Lurch FMR on Twitter.
Thank you for spending your mornings with us. Stick around, though, because Bill O'Reilly coming up next, followed by Ed Till from noon until 3. Shando Yefrey be here from 3 until 7, along with DJ, and that's all I'm going to say about that. Mm. I just don't. We're hoping someone else. Don't worry. Listen to Shannon Burke from 3 to 7. All right? Real Talk with G Love from 7 to 8. My boy Logan Seculo and his reprogram now from 8 until 9. We'll be back with you again tomorrow morning. We follow Bubba the Love Sponge, who's here from 6 until 10. Brianna, I don't know much, but I do know one little thing.